Hello everyone, myself Indranil Roy. Welcome to my channel News Biology. Today we are going to see how to prepare a slide of stomata. To perform this experiment, we have required leaf from where we will collect the epidermal peel, means the stomata, saffron stain to give color to the stomata, water to wash excess stain, glycerin to avoid drying and desiccation of the stomata, slides where I will give the epidermal peel, cover sleeve that helps to cover the epidermal peel, one forceps, scalpel, brush, scissor, blade, and to soak excess stain, absorbent paper, and finally a compound microscope to observe the stomata. We can perform this experiment by two methods. The first method is, first of all, we need to take one leaf and then we need to tear the leaves in such a way that it's in the opposite direction of the venation. After tearing of the leaves, here you can see I have got a transparent epidermal peel. Here you can see I have got a transparent peel. And then I'll be taking this peel on the slide after cutting it with the help of a blade. So here we need to cut that epidermal peel by the help of a blade. Another method you can also follow. First of all, you need to take one leaf and one forceps. What to be done? You just hold that leaf tightly, and after that you just try to scratch on the lips by the help of this forceps. After scratching, you can see very easily you can get epidermal peel by this step. So these are the two alternative techniques to prepare a slide of stomata. After collecting these two epidermal peel by these two different method, I will pour saffron stain, which is red in color. I will give a very little drop of saffron stain in both of the slides, and then I will wait for 30 to 40 seconds. After 30 seconds, I will take one drop of water in both of the slides to avoid excess staining, and finally I will use one drop of glycerin in both of the slides to prevent drying and desiccation of the epidermal cell. Glycerin also avoid air bubbles inside the slide. After pouring glycerin, I will use cover slip to cover the epidermal cell, but I will make sure that my cover slip does not have any fingerprint in it. So I will clean my cover slip, and afterwards I will hold my cover slip at an angle and then slowly I will place it on the epidermal peel. After placing the cover slip, if there is a excess stain coming out from the edges of the cover slip, then I will use absorbent paper to soak the excess stain. So now your slide is ready for further observation.
Stomata are the microscopic pores present in the epidermis of leaves and young shoots of plants. They are chiefly concerned with the exchange of gases during photosynthesis and respiration. Stomatas are also responsible for the loss of water through transpiration. After completion of procedure, now I will observe my slide under the 10x, and after that I will observe my slide under the 45x magnification. Under the 10x magnification, the epidermal cells are visible, which are irregular in outline and have no intercellular spaces. Many small pores are seen scattered among the epidermal cells, and all the pores is guarded by two bean-shaped gut cells, each containing chloroplast and a nucleus. The inner concave boundary of each gut cell is thick, whereas its outer boundary is thin. The stomatas can be open or can be closed, and the opening and the closing of stomata, it is completely depend on the gut cells. During the time of transpiration, when water move inside the gut cells, as a result, gut cells become swell up. So that time, the stomata is called as the open stomata due to the opening of the pores. Once the water that move out from the gut cells, as a result, the gut cells become shrink, and that time the stomatal aperture become closed, and this is called as closed stomata.
So this is all about the process by which we can prepare a slide of stomata. Through this video, I am trying to show there are two alternative methods by which you can extract the epidermal peel. One method to tear the leaves against the vegetation, and another method to collect the epidermal peel by the using of forceps. If you like this video, please subscribe my channel Nils Biology, where biology is everything. Please hit the bell icon to get regular updates. Thank you very much.